Hey guys, today I'm going to, instead of really working out, I'm just gonna stretch on the couch, and I'm watching this show. I found this show that's called Love It or Lose It, and it's really awesome, because, okay, so people have to, I don't know, you guys should just watch the show, but people, have to, like, let designers, and they don't know which designer. The one for this couple, there's this elderly couple on this episode that the designer that they wanted the least is the one they got. And, you know, which probably happens a lot. I don't know. This is just the second episode I'm watching. But it's really funny. It's good. But, okay, so the designers make over this whole room, whatever room the people choose, and then the homeowners get to decide when they come back if they're gonna love it or lose it. And I have a feeling these guys are gonna lose it. Oh man, see, that's the problem though. It was hard because I was trying to get the TV in where you guys could see what I'm watching, but you're just gonna have to watch it on your own. Alright, I gotta move the camera now. So, hold on. I'm coming. Hold on. I'm coming. Yeah, he's like an Indian designer, and, I mean, he's not like an Indian. He designs for, like, Hindu and India feel. Like, rich colors and all this. But, you know, whoops, I just shut the camera off, so I don't actually know what you're seeing right now. Because I have too many open apps, and now it's just looking at another. So, we will put you guys back over here. Alright, hold on, are you still bearing with me? Eventually I'm going to be doing what I said I'm going to do. Okay. So now, I'm going to stretch. I'm going to put a microphone. That's the nice thing about having a microphone. But, anyway. Okay, so. Alright, now you can watch me watch a show and stretch. Okay, but this is really cool show because, like, oh man. I would probably lose it if anyone. I already do design whatever I want. You know what, though? If I was this. Ow! Hold on, hold on. Show is going fast. I think it's like a half hour show, and since I skip commercial, you know, I don't skip commercial breaks, but Amazon Prime does it for me. Or Netflix, all those streaming services. So the shows that were supposed to be half an hour end up being like 7 minutes because the majority of the show is commercials if you're watching it on live TV. That's why I don't understand why. Well, I still watch live TV every now and then, but, oh, yeah, see, I think it looks cool, but I don't like the curtains. Yeah, I don't know, it's not that great. I would not like that design as much. I would like a modern design, something that is really, sometimes to get my legs to go that way, sometimes I have to do both of them at first. I'm trying to get in, like, a cross-legged position. But, anyway, it is pretty unromantic, but yeah, I would lose it. I would lose it! It's okay, but it's pretty crazy. I wouldn't like it. It's just not my style. Like, some people like that stuff. You see my socks? I say, what do I say? Smile. Oh, good. Today's a good day for smiling. So do it. Smile. Now. They're gonna hate it. These people are gonna hate that room. They're gonna hate it. I think maybe they'll love it. Maybe they'll be like, oh, this is amazing. But odds are, no. Yeah, they totally.
What do you think? It's amazing. Yeah. It's not complete. It's very rich. Mm-hmm. It's
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. For my body, like basically I'm just trying to get in the habit of forcing myself to do things that are really good for me, because due to a whole lot of, I don't know, like my life, I have a really bad habit of not taking care of myself. I had a death wish for a long time, and then I mean, not really, but you know how people get, like, you kind of just are, you expect yourself to screw up, you expect yourself to, like, I'm dying anyway, I'm sick anyway, I'm hurting anyway, so why try to, like, make myself, you know, why try to keep function when there's no way I can, you know, actually. But I'm trying to change that mindset because there's a lot of reasons, and I've gotten to the point now where, like, I do think in some ways it was good. I'm glad that I stopped trying to walk. I really am glad about that because, you know, I would fall all the time. I spent all my time and energy trying to walk. So I'm glad I, you know, realized that was a losing battle, but there are some things that, even if they are a losing battle, it's still a battle worth fighting. You know, like my hands, like, okay, so they're getting numb, they've been getting numb for several years, but now they're getting more and more, like, issues with them. That doesn't mean I just let it happen. Because, I let it happen with my legs. I was finally like, you know what, screw it. I am done trying to walk. I'm done trying to spend all my time and energy trying to walk across the room. And it would scare me to death. I was scared to walk across an open room because my balance was so bad and stuff. But I gave up on that. And I'm glad I gave up on that battle, but I don't want to give up on my hands. I need my hands. I do art. I write. I need my hands. And so it's good for me to do stuff, but then also with issues like what I'm doing now, this is really important for me. It's as important as working out with Nancy, as doing the other stuff, all that. It's important for me to stretch my arms up high, like, that's another thing I'll do while I'm sitting here and watching this Love It or Lose It show. Then I can just stretch and stuff, because like some battles are worth fighting, you know, and so I've got to fight, but other battles are not worth fighting. Like sometimes you have to realize, like, weigh the benefits and the risks of what you're doing. Like, okay, so if I don't do this with my legs, like what I'm doing with my legs right now, it really helps stretch, like, this tendon right here. It's still, as you can see, I can't pump my knees down very much. But if I do this on a regular basis, then, you know, hopefully I would get more flexible. But also, it's not just I need to get flexible. It's because the pain is so intense. And I think that one of the reasons it is so intense is because I don't stretch enough. I spend a lot of time in the same position. I spend a lot of time in the seated position. And stuff like that. So anything that I can do that can stretch is a good thing. And then hopefully if I do these 30 days, which I'm doing good, this is 7 days, right? But just getting in the mindset, like, wait a second, every day I'm going to spend at least, like I'm saying, right around 15 minutes. I'm going to spend at least 15 minutes doing something that is good for me, physically. Like, something that is just good for my body, because it's important, because I want to be around as long as possible, because I want to be able to wash my own hair. I want to, be able, you know, to do whatever else. Okay. Try, see, I can do. Yeah. That, I can do that with this leg, kind of. But that's because this leg is more atrophied, and, so I can stretch it like that. I should do this. Like, I don't know. So I've got my leg up. Got it. Enjoy it while I heard my hip pop and felt it pop like 2 or 3 times. But it's because my hips are not used to moving in this kind of way either. In any kind of way. I've got to do it. I've just got to suck it up and realize that it's important, it's more important, really, to take care of yourself than it is to take care of other people. Because if you can't take care of yourself, you can't take care of other people. If you don't take care of yourself, you're not going to be able to take care of the loved ones, the people in your life. Because I do spend a lot of time trying to do things for others and take care of others and, you know, just help people out and do stuff for other people. But yeah, like, I've got to do stuff for myself too, because if I'm not taking care of myself, I'm not going to be able to take care of other people or to help them out in any way. I'll just be more of a burden on other people, and that would suck. See, this leg, okay, so I can't, like, there's no way I could stretch it out like I was doing with my right leg, but especially now, I gotta get my right even up here, because it fell off the couch. So, okay, now my left, like, it can't decide. I don't know if it's gonna, okay, how Oh, it's already 14:30. Yeah, I should totally just make it. I mean, I'm gonna do this for more than 15 minutes today just because it feels really good already. Like, it feels like, oh, I don't know, at least I'm not sitting in the same position. But I wish I could lift my leg up like how I did with my right and just stretch it out, but there's no way I could. One, because it's too heavy. Like, since I have more muscle in that leg, it's heavier, you know? Like, my right leg is still kind of heavy. It still has muscle because of my spasms and stuff, but my left leg is way too heavy. Plus, like, right now, since it's not spasming on its own, then it almost, like, spasms the other way. It remains tense. And that's why, actually, yeah, there it goes. Okay. Now it's stretched. So that's good. But even if I, even if I tried to, like, pick it up, like, what I do sometimes when my legs are, like, for whatever reason, I use my clothes. That's another reason I like knee-high socks. Because sometimes I'll pull on, like, my knee-high to lift my leg. Because I can reach that. Sometimes I wish my legs had handles on them. See the designers. I don't know what options they had. I don't even remember what the people were like. Wow, see, I started getting distracted making this video. So maybe I'll stop it here in a little bit and just watch my show and stretch and try. Well, I need to do a couple of other things, though. I need to do my dishes still. Like, I rinsed them off that one day, and then I have to unload the dishwasher and load it back up and that stuff. This is what I do too sometimes when I'm stretching. Like, if I have TV or something on, then it distracts from, like, the pain and stuff too. Because, of course, stretching does feel really good, but it also hurts. Artificial flowers. Aisles and aisles of fabric. How do we know which ones are Victorian? It's really easy, Tamara. You go on down to a store like this, you can ask advice from a professional, or you can ask people who have designed beauty sets for that period, or you can even take out books and have a look at some pictures. So are these Victorian? Several of them are. Specifically the ones that have these large.
Yeah, see, I just don't like the Victorian style as much either. I think I'm more of a modern style, and then I do like, I mean, I think that stuff is pretty, but not, I wouldn't want it in my house. Like, the art on my walls that I have, you know, if you ever see, it's in tons of my videos, but they're actually calendar pictures, and I was kind of sad this year because the artist that was making them retired. And so I was like, oh no, I can't get my favorite kind of calendar, which is how I do art because, you know, you can just cut out the gallery pages and make them fit in frames, and then boom, you have $10 for a calendar, and you have a year of art, and then you can switch the pages out. Like, most of my frames have 2 or 3 different pictures behind each one because I just cut them out every year, and then I have more. I need to cut out last year's stuff. That was the last calendar. Trying to use my elbows to push my legs down and the couch to hold myself up. They always get the people they want least. Like, how does that happen? It's like, they probably picked. Okay, this is the one they didn't want most. That'll get good TV reactions. Let's do it. Producers. Just think it looks weird. You guys should watch the show. It's a really good show, actually. It's very interesting. Trying to kind of, like, bend over my legs. Just to, that's stretching. I mean, I could just, you can feel it when your stretches are actually stretching. And it feels like it really totally is stretching a lot, so I'm gonna keep doing it for now. Interesting. I'm thinking crafty stuff. It hurts. I'll wait until I see this thing. See what they think of their new show. With our final minutes ticking away, the dress code explodes with rich colors. dun dun dun, moment of truth. You're gonna lose it. You can see it already. What do I need to do?
The Dresco's featureless living room has become a suburban Moulin Rouge with a profusion of Gothic and Victorian design motifs.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. Oh, the toilet, toilet seat thing. And the trash is in the bathroom.
The space is now surging with color.
Get that.
Dominated by rich shades of red and green and segmented by the addition.
Yeah, I don't like that at all. I would lose it too. Fireplace is kind of cool, but
creating a new focal point for the room.
Yeah, I would lose it.
Nearby, a spectacular floral display mounted on a heavy Gothic column commands the corner adjacent to the games table. These elaborate details, luxurious fabrics, and sophisticated textures create a room that is worthy of 19th century aristocracy. Luann, I can't believe this is the same living room. You are amazing.
Whatever. Just bring the people in. Bring them in. Let them see it. They're gonna lose it.
Are you nervous? Really?
Yeah.
It's 5:30 this morning. Okay. On the count of three, this is gonna blow your mind. On the count of three, I want you to take off your blindfolds.
Fireplace is cool.
So you know what question I have to ask you guys? If you love it or if you want to lose it.
Right.
Well, no,
we love it.
Yes, you don't. You never know what's gonna happen. Go watch that show. Bye.